Hi everyone, my name is Youngan Kim, owner of Kim's Ramyeon in KMALL, Philippines. I'm going to show you what Kim's Ramyeon is about, especially our special instant ramyeon cooking machine. We have some Korean noodle and Korean food and some ice cream, so I will just show you one by one. So let's go inside. Since our business is based on the online shopping mall, we were selling all kind of Korean beauty products. So as you can see, we have skincare and makeup. Let's move over there. We have some Korean grocery food. We have some dry food and we have some frozen food inside of the wrap. Especially we have lots of Korean cup noodle and the pouch noodle. This is the liquid part. We have some Korean drink, the alcohol drink, and some milk, and some coffees, and even Korean mineral water. And we have some rice cake that we can cook the tteokbokki as you like. Some frozen food that you can cook in your house, not only in your house, also here in our cooking machine. When you cook ramyeon, you can just add up some of our frozen food as a topping. I have started my business with online shop first last 2010. 2016, we have launched our official Korean online store, KMALL PH. And now, still we are operating. We are selling all kinds of Korean products. We import also some of the unique product from Korea and introduce in the Philippines. And the reason why I started this business because I know every Filipino loves noodle, especially Korean noodle. That's why we just launched Kim's Ramyeon. This is our special noodle display. As you can see, you can choose any of your pouch noodle, then after you choose, you can just go over there to choose also many toppings before you cook. You can just choose the noodle what you like. Then we have three kinds of the container. The aluminum foil, and this is the paper base. And we have also stainless. So you can choose any container you like. So let's choose this stainless. Then you can also choose the menu of toppings what you like. We have 12 kinds of topping. Then one topping costs 15 peso. And it costs 50 peso for cooking charge. So it'll cost about 80 to 120 depending on how many toppings you choose and what noodle you choose. So after you choose the topping and noodle, you can just pay here. Even though we supply the Korean product for wholesale, we are focusing on the machine. That's our main features. Most of our sales from this item. Many people, many suppliers has Korean product, right? So they compete too much. The profit of the selling the Korean product become really small. But in our Kim's Ramyeon store, there's no competitors for this business. That's why. As long as the place is good for working people, the profit would be really good. Actually, the sales from the online store is deteriorate because, as you may know, there are open market, Shopee and Lazada. There are too much of competitors. So we have decided we need something unique, something special, what really Filipino like. So we have researched the market in Korea, then there is some advanced machine in Korea which is really booming in Han River and many other convenience stores. So we became the first distributor of the machine with the business itself. You can just simply touch manual one and start. Then it will be automatically start cook. Stir some while it's cooking to avoid the burning. Just on a quantila. Okay, then just wait for the time. Okay, after 1 or 2 minutes, you can just add up the. After 4 minutes, it's already done, then you can enjoy. The sales of our store become double by 1 month only. Even though after we launched, the sales was already big enough, but the current sales already become double by 1 month. Based on our sales record in this store, our average sale is about 30,000 peso per day. Sure, it's depending on the sales of our ramen mainly. But if you sell about 150 pieces of the noodle, then the sales is about 300,000 or over average. Then your profit will be about 20 to 30%, depending on the sales price. At the beginning, we suggest to rent or to buy our ramen machine for installment with a small budget, because it costs only about 1,000 to 2,000 pesos per month for renter and for installment. Then the ROI will take about 1 or 2 months only to get back the investment of your money for the ramen machine and ramen. If you can invest only less than $1 million, you can operate Kim's Ramen with the whole, with all necessary things. So it's gonna cost minimum about 500,000 to open almost similar of Kim's Ramen. Then maximize, if it's big space, it may cost about 1 million. We plan to make also our own branches with some franchise. But for franchise, we're still working on that. We have planned to branch out over 5 to 10 branches. Then we will have the correct record of the ROI, then we will provide it. We have a variety of the ice cream, so you can see. The Melona, the best seller, Melona. And there's many different kind of ice cream. Actually, our sales price is almost wholesale price, so that everybody just can experience first. We offer some rebate for bulk order. So if you have some, if you have interest to sell or resell our Korean product, you can just contact us. Then we can just show you, and you can just share all the supply price. There are some restrictions for foreigners to have some business like a retail, but fortunately, the law for retail was changed last December. So as long as your capital is over 20 million, then you can have your own retail retail business. The first thing is the people. You have to be always careful to choose the right person. And also, you have to be always patient until your people can be real partner of your business.
Can you tell us the story of when you applied big patient for the business?
Every day.
Why?
See, doing a business is like a war. And there is always a problem, but the key is always from the people who you work with. So whenever there is a problem in your business, you have to solve the problem with your people. It's been 12 years since I started my own business here in the Philippines. And there was a time that I got down and bankrupt and that I started over again. So I'm still alive. So meaning that do never give up once you start your business. Then you will learn the lesson. Every failure, actually I don't want to say the term of failure, but whenever you experience the bad luck or the down of your business, do never give up. Then there will be time to go up again. Once you are bankrupt, once you have failed, syempre in the financial, you may be totally bankrupt, meaning that you may have some debt, of course. But as long as you have the people, you have good people around of you, you still have a chance to overcome, then start it over again. Okay, this is our warehouse at the back of our store. And we just storage our Korean product, especially the one we are selling, the noodle and the ice cream and everything, okay? And this side is for the storage room for the KMALL online store. So there is some clothing and some cosmetics. And actually, we are still in construction to expand our store. And this way is going to my office. Actually, this space is not really expensive for renter because I have constructed this one as a new. There was nothing here before, so it costs a lot for construction, more than renter. I have to operate a while to get back the revenue again for my investment. Because whenever I talk about this story, some of my friends cried. Actually, it's been a long years since I visited the Philippines first time when I was early 20s. And I have started studying English here in Cebu first time. And after a few years as a student, I have a chance to join the Habitat, the volunteering program in Palawan. So as I remember, it was 2006. And when I visit the Palawan, the habitat section area for construction to help to build the new houses for some people in the village. Then one day, while I was doing my workout for construction, I have met a little cute babies, cute kids. They were about 5 and 6 years old. I got really touched with the kids. Even though I was not allowed to meet them personally, they always hold my hand and brought me to their house to give me some food and some water. And day by day, I really got to love them. I felt at home. I felt very special because of the kids, not only the whole family. I mean, not only the kids, but also the whole family. They were really kind, like my family, even though we just met the time. Then when I was about to leave the Palawan to go back to Korea, I just left some the letter to keep in touch with them. After I came back to Korea, there was something left in my heart all the time. So when I was about to search my job, first job, after graduation of my university.
By the way, what did you study?
Actually, my major was naval architecture related with the shipbuilding. That's why I entered the Hanjin Heavy Industries, because the company, in coincidence, that company built a new shipyard, huge shipyard in the Philippines, in Subic. So I felt it's kind of destiny, which brought me, can bring me to the Philippines back again to meet the family, especially. So I have decided to enter the company. Then after 2 years, I volunteered to go to Subic, the Subic shipyard. It was my first time to be touched with the Pinoy people, especially the kids who couldn't speak English at all. So we just communicated with our hand in like body language. We just spoke different language. But day by day, whenever we became close, we didn't really need the same language. And, you know, as I told you, whenever when I was about to leave the Palawan, I really felt that I need to meet them again, even though I didn't know when. When I visited the Palawan second time, I think it was after 4 to 5 years since I have met them again. I have decided myself already to support the family before I visit them, because the purpose of the meeting and the visiting the Palawan was to offer them my supporting for the, especially for the children. And when I visit there, I made a promise with their parents to spend all my supporting to their children until they graduate. And it's been almost 15 years that I started it. One of the kids was studying hard, and she was able to apply the university here in Manila, and she got even tuition fee for free, a scholarship. She got a scholarship for 4 years. Even she got provided dormitory also for free because of her good study. Then while she was studying in Manila, there was pandemic, diba? Then during the pandemic, actually she was staying here with me, and she also worked for KMALL for my business for her part-time job. And fortunately, she could graduate with a good score also. Actually, three are graduate already, but only one just came to Manila for her study, but two of them just finished their school in Palawan. The first one, I forgot the name.
Hotel restaurant,
like that. Then second one for the government government office. So she's still working, and she's working for government office there in Palawan. Third one was the one came to Manila for university, and recently she graduated.
What did she study?
Accounting. So she planned to work for KMALL as accountant after her, board exam.
Mm-hmm.
But I recommended her to work out of KMALL, I mean the other company first, for her good experience. Actually, I'm really a lucky person, lucky Korean, because I have many Philippine family here in the Philippines. They invited me as their one of their family member. In Korea, I was living alone for long years since I was 14 years old because of my parents' business. So I used to living alone, but here in the Philippines, especially my many Philippine family, they treat me as their family member. So it took only a few days after they met me first time, meaning that they really opened to me very fast. So they didn't, there was no condition. And they didn't test me. One of my family is my friend's family, actually. And he was my business partner. And when I was bankrupt, he just provided me the accommodation in their house. And their grandmother just called me as anak. After a few days, just like that.
He's Filipino.
Yeah, they are Filipino. Just like that. So I became their son. Because as a foreigner, it's really hard to find that kind of Philippine. I mean, to meet that kind of Philippine. So it's really special for me. Of course, every bankrupt businessman might be experience the worst in their life, but they must know that it will not be the last. They can be bankrupt more than two or three times. So that's why I mentioned a while ago, never give up, because that's not the end yet. Whenever you are bankrupt, whenever you feel like a bankrupt, that's not the end yet. You can go down worse, more. Whenever you feel the bottom, there's no space to get down. There's only space to go up again. So you don't have to think that it's the end of your life. We got offer from SM, the Fisher Mall, Ayala.
Really?
Yeah. They want to lease the space to us.
Wow. Because what do you think about that?
It's because of the people's posting.
Yeah.
They share all their experience with our Kim's Ramen.
So do you plan to open in malls?
Yeah, of course.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
At least 10 branches within this year. So that we can have this kind of enough data of the sales. This data can be the backgrounds of ROI. Because for franchises, they have to invest their money. So they must know after how many months they can get back their the fund, I mean the investment fund, then earning, after that earning, diba?
What do you see though in the future? Because China, there are a lot of things made in China, talking by China.
You know what? Actually, it's been 10 years they made this machine in Korea. But it took 10 years to be famous. And I know that there is, there will be similar copy of the machine.
Yeah.
But the machine is not the key. The way how we operate. Because how many different kind of cell phone in the world? There are a lot, right? Just like that. Even though they're the same machine, it's not depending on the machine only. So I can say it may be depending on the how we operate our service to people. Even the interior, the Korean noodle, or the way how we service to our customers.
There are a lot of people who started Korean groceries.
Yes.
Do you see that? A lot of people also start.
We supply our machine to them now.
How about that there are a lot of Koreans who started to supply the same machine?
There are only a few manufacturers in Korea, and I'm connected with them. So we.
They're not allowed to distribute the product
in the Philippines.
I'm
an exclusive distributor of all the machine in the Philippines. That's why. There will be no competitors for the meantime. That's why I want to introduce about this franchise business and this machine as many Filipino investors or resellers, many of the businessmen, because my first purpose of this this machine is to help the current existing businessmen, especially the retailer, to boost up their sales with our machine. Or the people, after pandemic, there might be many of new franchises, I mean, new investors who wants to start their own business. Then it costs really small amount compared to other big franchises. So I think it's gonna be good chance for them to invest for their good revenue.